I praise God for our faithful partners that make it possible for New Life to be there when people are hurting. So many people struggling with utilities at this time. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. With me, a dear sister. She's got her cane with her. I've heard she had a knee replacement.
Yes. I'm 73 years old. This is the second time you've helped me. 2 years ago, and I even came back and did some volunteer work.
Thank you.
Stephanie, she used to work for you.
All right.
She used to be your receptionist. And I remember seeing you on TV many, many times downtown trying to work with the homeless and to keep them, keep your doors open and the city and whoever else worked against you.
I'm going to give you an action packet that tells you how you can help us to get the place open back up, okay?
Oh, I'll help you.
All right. Well, we're going to get you that action packet because we're encouraging people to call the Department of Justice right now, the Civil Rights Division, because we've experienced what it is to be a victim of the discrimination of not allowing our church to open back up because we're helping homeless people and they don't want them in the neighborhood. And that St. Louis Board of Building Appeals says we're not going to let you open because you may want to help those people, might want to shelter them. And so they're not doing that. So then we want a church.
We're living in times we're missing love, unity, peace, grace, and mercy.
Amen.
We're missing that so much. And you would think it would be better by now, but it's not. And, you know, we're judging people. And we shouldn't, because we don't know. We a day, an hour, a second away from being homeless ourselves, day by day. You know, my mother passed away, be 3 years next month. And I never forget how loving she was to anybody, anybody.
Yes.
She never taught us about color, or about the condition somebody was living in, or anything. One time I remember her telling me, I was asking her, who was she taking that food for? She went in our freezer, our deep freezer, we're getting food, and she told me to never question her about her giving and who she's giving to. And I swear for God, I didn't know we were poor till I saw her take some newspaper and wrap it and put it in the bottom of her shoe, and she had a hole this big in her shoe. But we never went hungry. Her and my father divorced in the 50s. She was a housekeeper. She cleaned people's house, five different families, and they were wealthy. And she had keys to every one of them's house. One of them, I told her when time got tough or whatever, she always spoke of them highly. Mm-hmm. But I told her there was going to be one of those families that she thought would help her when she got older. Because by her getting paid under the table, she didn't have Social Security. But when my father passed, she was able to get it. But before then, there was one of the family sons that supplemented her income. For over 10 to 12 years, sent her Valentine's card, Mother's Day card, all of that.
Amen.
And she lived till she was 93.
She knew, and others know that do this, it's more blessed to give than to receive.
Oh, I know that for a fact myself.
Amen. Well, praise God. You know, tell me about now your utility bill. You're having a hard time paying it.
Yes.
How much is that?
Oh, it's $485 and some cents.
How did it be so high?
Well, found out the house I'm living in, I've been leasing it for 7 years. The furnace and the central air unit did need to be replaced.
Yeah.
And the house was built in the 50s. So I guess this system might have been replaced back in the 80s or something, you know, just been patched up. My main thing was I just wanted to live in a nice neighborhood, clean, where there was people around my age, okay, and not in an apartment, okay? So this person goes to my church. The Spirit told me one day to get up and ask around in the church, somebody got a house for you in this, and I did. I got it.
You got it?
I got it.
But now you have a hard time paying that bill.
That bill.
How'd you end up coming to New Life?
Well, I seen you all on TV a long time ago, and then they got that 211 number you call with your utilities and stuff. And my rent has went up. You know, groceries, I'm not able to get food stamps or anything like that. There's a certain, you know, limit on everything. You either a few dollars over of receiving certain things. You don't work all your life. I don't work 47 years of my life. And I don't get me wrong, I guess it's a decent amount, but it doesn't cover everything.
Well, you keep us in your prayers, too. They just made an announcement. Our elevator.
They're supposed to be disconnecting my gas, well, so I don't know.
You. We're going to help you, but I want you to pray for us because I just heard our elevator's out of commission. And
I just heard about that.
And I have this. I got a lot of needs I need you to pray for.
Well, guess what?
You pray for
I'm
us.
A praying woman.
Oh, I need it.
Guess what? My favorite saying is, Lord, I'm not complaining. I'm just explaining.
Oh, amen. That's a good one. Not complaining, just explaining.
Just explaining.
Well, we've got a lot of explaining.
Because I said, when she said about the elevator, guess what I said? Oh, I'm glad it's somebody else because I have claustrophobia.
Oh, what? Yeah.
Gotta be stretched out somewhere.
I got to tell you about it. You know, we have a lady that was just in a major accident, okay? She came to us. She lost her car. Everything's in it. We're trying to help her to get her stuff out of her car. She gets on the elevator, and now the elevator needs to be repaired, and she's in it. And as I run around to help her, the Holy Spirit says, you need to help that lady get her car out of hock because it's going up $50 a day. So she sat in there, but some good's going to come out of it.
You know, wait a minute. You'd be so surprised because the times I have given and seem like those things come too because the devil don't like you to give.
That's what it is.
And he's a liar.
And he's going to help that lady. He's going to help you. Jesus is going to do that because the devil's a liar.
Woo!
Jesus is going to help you.
He can't stay. He got to go to that door and open that door and say, you got to go. You can't stay in here because I've had to go to my front door and let him out because he didn't want to leave.
Devil's a liar. Jesus is Lord. He's given the saints an opportunity right now to stand up against this bigotry of keeping a church closed that wants to live out the gospel of Jesus Christ.
And you are a strong man. You know that?
Pray for us.
You're a strong man.
Oh,
you've been fighting a long time. And look at you.
Well,
you know what?
Well,
the more they try to put your name, the more he keep making you stronger.
You know this. I know this. Faith that can't be tested can't be trusted. So, Lord, help us as you test us, okay?
Gonna be all right.
God is good. And
it's gonna be all right. You watch and see.
Praise God. And I thank God for the sisters and the brothers that I have a chance to meet along the road of life. I thank God for each one of you. Please continue to keep us in your prayers here at New Life Evangelistic Center.
Good morning. Who do we have here today? What is your name?
Kathy. Kathy Anderson.
Kathy, how are you today?
I'm okay.
Good. And tell us why you're here today.
I'm here to get some energy assistance. I'm here to get some energy assistance help. Everything is just so high right now, and I have children at home, so I'm on a fixed budget, and I just really needed the help, and I called up to Larry Rice, and when I call, they're always there for me when I need help.
Amen. And Kathy, have you tried other places to get assistance?
Yes, I've tried other places, but genuinely it takes a while for them to get back to you. I have like a due date for my bill right now, and I like Reverend Rice is the only one that gets you immediate assistance.
Okay. And isn't it nice to know that you can come here and get help, the help that you need?
Yes.
And are you facing any other pressures in life? And are your utilities being threatened to be cut off, or are they cut off?
My electric is being threatened to get cut off right now. So, and just food. I'm being helped with food from up at Larry Rice. He's helping me. They're helping me with food and also my electric bill. So that's a big help right now because I ran into some difficulties this month. And a lot of people, just so many people are out here struggling right now. I'm just glad and blessed to be able to come here for help.
And Angela, we're glad to be able to help you. And we're grateful that we are here to be able to help you. And how did you hear about New Life?
I've heard of them. I've had a long history with New Life since they were down on Locust. Okay. I've actually spent a couple of days there when I was homeless. And they really helped me out then. I have 6 children and... just every time I was in need of help, it's been a few times over like a long span of years, but I was always able to get help and help to get back on my feet, but I was always able to get that help that I needed.
Okay. And you know that 1411 Locust is now closed right now, and we're trying to get that building back open. And how important is prayer to you?
Prayer is very important to me because I know God answers my prayers. So it's very important to me. And just hoping that I'm able to just continue my relationship with God and my prayers continue to go answered.
Amen. That's good. And so Angela's here, and she is asking for help. And will you help her? Will you help us get 1411 Locust back open? We receive no city, state, or federal funds. New Life is here to provide food and clothing, safe houses for women and children. We have a 1 to 2 year residential training program. And we're trying to help prevent people from being homeless and being out on the streets. So we continue to help with foreign missions and, of course, spiritual guidance. So New Life is doing great things down here, and we want you to be a part of it. Will you help us? Thank you.
I'm here with another. What's your first name?
Tanisha.
Okay. And tell me a little bit about what's going on in your life right now and why you are in need.
Well, I have a job, but I'm living alone, and I have so many bills. It's only me paying them, so I'm reaching out for help, and I'm taking advantage of it if I can.
So you've got a lot of different bills that are going on. Is it hard to keep track of all of them?
Yes, it's hard. It's hard doing it by yourself.
It is really difficult, and there's very little affordable housing, so... what are some of the things that have kind of led to you slipping behind a little bit?
City.
Like, how have we fallen behind a little bit? What are some of the things that have happened?
Well, first I tried to pray and leave it in God's hands, but I also tried to seek out for help. And once again, I tried to seek out for help. I just Google a lot of different places. I ask family members, do they know anything? And that's how I get it.
So first you prayed about it. How important is prayer in your life?
It's very important. God is real. He's real. I believe in him.
And so you're trying to faithfully just live and work and do your best. But that can be challenging sometimes. We fall on hard times.
Yes. It's very challenging, but I stay above water, and like I said, I just pray and go from there. I just...
You know that God loves you.
Yeah.
And even in slipping behind, you're seeing God's love in the other people who are coming alongside you and helping.
Yes.
What would you say to people who... I mean, they just don't know the need. They've never really experienced the need that you're in right now. How would you encourage them to get involved?
I would just say try your best. Do your best. And as long as you put one forward, God will lead you the way. He will.
Absolutely. Well, it is so important that we come alongside other people and help serve in really practical ways. We want our faith to be seen and witnessed and felt. And so that's how we're helping. We want you to see this and come alongside us and help even more people. Thank you so much for coming in and talking with us.
There's so many people that are in need. Tell us your name.
My name is Ariel.
Ariel, how come you're here today?
I needed a little help on my electric bill today.
What is that?
I fell behind on bills due to school starting back. I'm a single mother, so it can be, you know, hard times for me sometimes.
Hard times for you.
Yeah.
But God's going to make a way.
I believe so.
God's going to make a way. We're going to try to help you some today, but we need your prayers. You know that?
Mm-hmm.
We need all of your praying. How'd you fall behind? Going through some hard times. What's
happening?
God's gonna make a way.
I just needed to hear that.
You want to get back closer to Jesus, do you?
I am really close.
Are you really?
But I just needed to hear that.
We all need to get closer and closer every day, you know?
Mm-hmm.
We never get close enough. He loves you. That's what he wants me to tell you today. He loves you. He's got a purpose for your life. We got a Bible study up there. I want you to get called Position for Purpose. Will you do that?
Mm-hmm.
And know that he's called you. And that's the good news. We want everybody to know that there's hope. Christ is risen. We're sharing that hope here at New Life Evangelistic Center. I'm asking all of you to keep us in your prayers as we just let the light and love of Jesus flow through us. We can't do it without you, caring partners. So please, get involved now. Share that gift with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Let the light and love of Christ flow through you. Let's go back to Candace.
And who do we have with us here today? What is your name?
Kenesha.
Kenesha. Glad to meet you.
Glad to meet you, too.
And how are you doing today?
I'm doing okay.
Okay. And why are you here today?
I'm here to get assistance towards my electric bill. I just got behind on it. Just some difficulties I'm dealing with. And, you know, I have lupus, so sometimes I'm not able to work enough hours to meet the bills and everything.
Okay, so that's a lot of stress and pressure on you. So you're facing... threatened to have your utilities off, or are they off?
Threatened to have them off.
And how does having lupus affect your daily life? Or do you go through a lot of pain, or what? Because I'm not exactly sure with it.
Yeah, it's a lot of, it's like, it bothers me in my joints. So some days it's similar like arthritis, but a little different. So it causes you, like in the morning time, it's like I'm more... It causes you to be fatigued, and okay. It's hard to get your day started because your bones and muscles be hurting most of the time. So I take medication for that. But like I said, some days it's better than others. So it just causes me not to be able to work like a full-time job. So that's what kind of caused me to get in the situation where, you know, I'm needing assistance and everything, yeah.
And that could be very stressful and a lot of pressure on you. I mean, it's already hard enough to have to get up to even go to a job. But then if you have to go and then you have to be in pain, that's kind of hard. So we're going to be praying for you regarding that. And so how did you, how do you feel about having to come here to get help?
Well, you know, at times I used to be very independent before the lupus and everything like that. So, you know, sometimes you taking stuff from people, you kind of be like, you know, leery or embarrassed, I guess, sometimes. But it's like everybody needs help. So, right. You know, you just be grateful the fact that people are willing to help, mm-hmm. You know, because it's kind of hard out here for everybody, you know, mm-hmm. Trying to manage bills, trying to go to work, you know, the cost of living. Just everything, like everything has gone up, so it makes it harder. And then you have kids, you know, you got to worry about taking care of the kids and providing the roof and rent. And so, I mean, I'm thankful. So
that's good that you're thankful. And That's what I was going to say. Isn't it good to know that you have a place that you can come and get help? And have you tried to get help from any other sources? And if so, what have they said?
I've tried like Urban Lead, but I kind of just put the application in. I haven't heard anything back yet. But like I've got online and tried the 211 number. Okay. So they give you like different numbers and stuff to call. So I've been contacting different people, but I haven't heard back from probably about three or four so far. So I haven't heard from anybody yet.
And is the 211 how you got to come here today?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. And so I just want to make a plea to our audience to to give to New Life. We don't receive any city, state, or federal funding. And we provide food and clothes and water and safe houses for women and children to come to have a place to get off the streets. And we provide the 1 to 2 year residential training program. And we're just trying to help people stay off the streets and prevent homelessness. And so we continue to provide transportation assistance and foreign missions. And of course, to us, the most important thing is the spiritual guidance that we give. So New Life is here doing great things, and we want you to be a part of it. Will you help us? Thank you.
I'm here with Ariana. Ariana, tell me a little bit about some of the things that are going on in your life right now.
Right now, I just started work, but for about 2 months, I was out of work. I was out of a job. I have a son, so I had to act proactively to get some assistance because I'm a teacher assistant. So when the kids were out of school, we didn't get paid for the 2 months that they were out of school. So unfortunately for me, because work stopped doesn't mean bills stopped. So I had to get some help with June and July to pay my rent. So my son's school guardian angel, who is also pays people's rent and stuff like that and assistance to them, they the one that gave me you all's number. And so I just jumped right on it immediately.
So you've been working really hard to kind of shore up the gap between employment, and then it just kind of snowballs. It makes it really hard to catch up sometimes, right?
Oh, yeah. And one thing I dislike about it, because I don't like to say hate, is you never know when it's coming. You never know. Life just going to hit you in the face, and you just got to deal with it. So, and me being from Chicago, I don't have no family, no friends out here, so I have to make it work with what I have. So
I was actually born in Chicago too, and raised on the north side of the city. And there's a lot of need in Chicago, isn't there?
Absolutely, and it's a need everywhere actually. But I was grateful to be able to have these resources presented to me while I'm in St. Louis, because I can always go back home, but I'm just trying to make things work the best way I know how out here. So, yeah.
The culture is a little different out here in St. Louis than it is in Chicago.
Okay. So, yeah, it is. It's a definitely a culture shock. You know, Chicago is a very, very big city. And when I came here, it was like St. Louis is like really small. So you have to, coming from a big city to a small city, a lot of changes you got to go through, a lot of new people you got to meet. I've always had a job since I was 16. I've always worked, and I never, ever fell on hard times. I never got behind no rent, never. So when this hit me, I was just like, oh, man. And I kind of shut down. I was like, God, how am I going to do this? And honestly, he been providing a way. So I'm just thankful to God that he was able to put certain resources and people in my life to help me get back on my feet.
And that's the way it works, honestly, is that sometimes nobody can guarantee that their situation now is going to be the same even in a couple of hours. And so we live by that faith, and God does have this way of providing in many different ways. And we're really seeing that play out in the lives of many when they come here. The assistance that we provide just adds to the assistance that they're gathering from other people, other sources. We want to be able to help more, and we want to be able to help more people. But really, the only way is by people like you are watching and saying, you know what, I'm tired of hearing about the need and not doing anything about it. I want to serve people who need that assistance, not just a handout, but really a hand up to help them continue to serve and live and glorify God in a variety of different ways.
Agreed. Yep.
Thank you so much for talking with us today, Ariana, and you have a great day.
Thank you so much.
Wow, what happened to your leg?
Taking my daughter some food. She, her and her family got COVID. The whole family, her and her husband, her three children got COVID, and I decided to take her some food over there, and I set it on the porch and tried to get in my car and fell, slipped, kind of went up the grass and stuff like that and slid and fell, and my one leg went one way and my foot went another way and it twisted all the way around. My bone stuck out 2-3 inches away from my leg. So they had to pop my leg back in place twice and I wound up having to have surgery. But the reason why my leg got broke is because I was taking my daughter and her family some food because her whole family had COVID. And she got COVID 3 times. And she still lives. She's still here to talk about it. You know, thank God. You know.
So you went through your trials and tribulations. Yes. And now, what is it, electric bill?
Yes.
It's coming up heavy. And how'd you end up contacting us here at New Life?
It was just me. I was in the hospital, and one of the social workers, you know, they Bowen's Hospital at St. Louis, King's Highway. One of the caseworkers just offered me some help and just said, hey, you know, I told her I probably needed help because I was going to be out for a while. And that's how I'm here.
Yeah, well, God is good, isn't he?
Yes, God is good all the time.
Hallelujah. Well, yes. I ask you to pray for all of us here, too.
Yes, I will. I'll pray for everybody. And I'm so glad to see you in person because I've seen you since I was in high school all my life, downtown, helping people, doing all kind of great things for St. Louis.
Okay.
Yes. And as a person, as I've gotten older, and you still here, and he still look good. He's good in part. He looks so, everything is real, Jesus. And this man is still looking good and still helping people. And it's a blessing for us in the community and everybody. And I thank God for you.
All I can do is say thank you, Jesus, for your daily strength and help.
Absolutely.
And direction. And
saints
like you that we need praying for us.
Yes.
Okay?
I appreciate you guys for being here.
I want to give you an action packet where I'm asking all the saints to call the Department of Justice.
Yes.
And complain about them shutting down our 1411 Locust building.
Yes, I remember that because that's over there by the old gas station. Remember, you used to go to the little metal copper doors, you go upstairs.
I'm going to give you a copy of that action packet. And you get people to call and tell them that it's wrong for them to close
down. I remember all of that. I remember all of that.
Because we want to help the homeless.
All you're doing is helping people. How can you not want to help people? How can people get upset about people wanting to help people? It's the one thing I don't understand. Jesus would want us to help people, you know?
Amen.
Help each other.
314-421-3020. We need all of you praying for us right now. And we want to help this lady and others. And there's so many. The need is so great that it takes all of you praying, caring, and sharing at this time so we can be there when people are hurting. And again, you can send those gifts to New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. Give online at NLECSTL.org. I just feel a need to pray. Lord, be with this sister right now. Strengthen her and so many others with their needs. Help us to know, Lord, that you're there in that time of need. You're a great God, and you're always faithful. Help us to keep looking to you in spite of the circumstances. You're bigger than they are. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Lord, for your provision. Amen.
Amen, Jesus.
Oh,
thank you,
Jesus.
Thank
God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you for still being here.
Yeah, well, we just want to be there, and God bless you. You're going to make
like,
it.
It's just real. You know, I would never thought in my life I'd have ever met you, you're real, and thank God.
And people dropping by here, 2428.
I didn't even know you guys were here.
Yeah, this is our new headquarters here. I love coming out, meeting you. If I'm here, a lot of times I'm on the road. My grandson, Chris Aaron, wonderful people. So
you got a great staff. Everybody's nice and kind.
You know, they were all homeless at one time themselves. And
it's okay. We all go through stuff, but you thank God that we here all still here to talk about it.
Amen. Well, praise God for all of you that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center as we continue to reach out through the love of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.